Thank you. Alright guys, I know that this was a little bit different than what I typically do. If you're new to these videos, what I typically do is an intro where I talk about what's going to be going down through the video, and then I do a voiceover telling y'all what I'm doing during the process. I didn't really want to do that on this one. I just wanted to go straight into the build, let y'all check it out, let y'all watch the whole thing, and I'm going to go ahead and break down the materials of this knife and the whole reason behind it being made. Now, if you're interested in that, awesome. If you're not, thank you for coming by. Make sure you subscribe. Now, for what went into this and the whole point behind making this knife. So, I had a billet that I had forged together, and it was a GoMine. So, it was a center core of 80 CRV2 with 15 and 20 on either side of that, and then 1095 on either side of that to make a five-layer stacked billet. Three of the layers welded really well, the other two, not so much. So what I ended up doing was grinding off one side of it because it had separated like that. So in this little section right here, we've got 15 and 20 and 1095, and then this one is 80 CRV2 center, and then 15 and 20 and 1095. So what I did was I turned it into a kiradashi with a chisel grind. So you can see those layers right there, 80 CRV2, 15 M20, and there is another layer right by this transition line. You can kind of see the line right there, and that is the 1095 outer layer. So on this side, you don't see any layers. On this side, you see all three. And then I did etch the whole entire spine, and you can see those layers all the way through it, which is really cool. Now, for things like the handle scales, we used black G10, and these are typically my liner material that I use. They're 1/8 inch thick, but I didn't want a very big scale, so that's why I went this. And then black micarta pins, super sleek. The whole point behind me making this knife was, you know, trying to take advantage of what did work within this billet and just go ahead and make a knife. You know, I've been practicing my forge welding, and in that process, I've had a whole bunch of failures because I'm getting used to what my process is within forge welding, and I do have a successful one that I'm working on right now, so there's a good thumbs up on that. But I wanted to go ahead and finish something and give y'all a video. Now, kiradashi, you could typically use it for woodworking and stuff like that. They use it for scoring and for doing all kinds of different things, but I'm going to be using this as a leather tool, cutting leather, and I'm just now getting into that process, and I want to have a nice tool that looks really cool, and that's what I'm going to be doing with this. My first kiradashi, I'm very happy with how it turned out. Hopefully you are too. If y'all would, let me know in the comment section. Tell me a little bit of, you know, if y'all think it's awesome or if y'all think that, you know, it's not awesome. We'll see how that goes. Guys, thank y'all for coming by. Thank y'all for checking this out. Y'all would give this video a thumbs up, share this video, one of my other videos. And if you have not yet, subscribe, okay? Turn on the notification bell so you get notified of the stuff that we have that's coming up, because we got a whole bunch of forge welding awesomeness coming up. All right, guys, thank y'all for coming by. Thank y'all for just watching this again. Y'all have an amazing day. Y'all stay safe out there. I'll catch y'all next time.